So the main ingredient for an old fashioned is whiskey. I'm not going to use that today, though. Now whiskey has taught me a lot.
12 minutes.
Recently, good. About being able to identify different flavours. So first in my old fashioned is lemon. Now this particular variety of lemon is called Eureka. It's grown all year round and has fantastic citrus and floral characteristics. So next is peach. I'm using a great variety of peach called Andros. It has a fantastic intense sweetness to it. And I've infused that with water and sugar overnight. It's under pressure using nitrous. It just really dissolves the fruit. Now it has been under pressure. I'm going to release this. It's going to be a little bit loud, so you'll have to excuse me. This is going to create a lovely syrup to go with the drink. A little time check, please.
Exactly 13 minutes, John.
Thank you very much. Alright, then we're going to add the syrup. Around 20 mils should be enough. I'm going to give this a little stir just to really combine those two flavours. So when I put it in front of you, just if you'd like to have a bit of a smell of the two. Then we're going to add the espresso on top of that, but we're not going to be finished there. Just wanted to recreate that lovely aroma that the espresso has. And how I'm going to do that is by using hops. The hops are used in the beer brewing process for the flavour aromatics.
14 minutes, John.
Thank you very much. So what I've done, I've got an American grown hop called Simcoe. It has fantastic floral and fruity characteristics. Now this has been steeped in cold water overnight. I'm just going to put a little bit of a spray on your drink. So first I'm going to add your espresso. So when I do spray over the top of your drink, give it a really good smell. Get your nose in deep.
30 seconds, John.
Thank you very much. So dive straight in, have a good smell. And then give it a really, really good swirl. Mix in all those flavours together and enjoy. And I think every year preparation gets easier. Obviously I've had a ridiculously awesome team behind me as well. So, yeah, I've probably learned more prepping for this year than I have in the last 2-3 years. So.
Okay. How long have you been putting this together and working with this coffee and getting it ready?
A lot of the routines only came around a couple of weeks before the London Heat. Then things changed a lot. The signature drink only this week. So a lot of things have to be changed.
Purely
down to my own stubbornness, I think.
So. Okay, well, I think that was a fantastic performance, worthy of last year's champion. Big round of applause again for John. Well done, John.
The final drink, which is contrastingly hot, really rich, chocolatey, got that cream note in there.
Okay, start.
Time
Good afternoon.
Starts.
My name is Maxwell. My wife and I have a small specialist coffee shop in the centre of Bath. Today, I'd like to explore with you the complex combination of espresso and steamed milk. Now, I'm fascinated by this relationship. How exactly do they work together? What's retained and what develops? And in certain unfortunate cases, how can a balanced, complex espresso almost be lost in milk? I think that I was missing the point, expecting the whole character of an espresso to just cut straight through milk. This doesn't consider the flavour of the milk itself, its fats, its sugars, its acids. I believe a cappuccino is the sum of its parts, and it's for this reason that I'm going to use my signature drink as an opportunity to explore this relationship from a different angle. But I'm going to tell you a lot more about that later. First of all, I'm going to serve you a coffee that can do both. It gives me everything I want from espresso, but it also combines with milk to create a stunning cappuccino. It's a blend with three components. We've got 40% of a Costa Rican finca de Lecho. This is pulp natural and grown in the Naranjo region. We've then got 40% of a naturally processed Capim Branco from Brazil. This coffee is grown in the Minas Gerais region. And last of all, there's 20% of a Colombian coffee. It's grown in the Huila region. It's from a farm called Edgar Salas. We've got a different processing method for each of the coffees in the blend. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to use this coffee to serve your cappuccinos today. Now, the milk I've chosen to use comes from a small organic Jersey herd close to our shop as well. What I love about this milk is its sweetness and texture, but also the way its fats carry certain complexities of the espresso. I'll prepare those for you now. Thank you.
I'm adding, it's my own. It was taken late last summer, and the bees have been foraging on herbs, garden flowers, and wildflowers. So this is going to add a real rich sweetness to the espresso. So what I've got warming on the table is a homemade lemongrass reduction, made with organic lemongrass and filtered water. And it's warming under my, well, it was, beeswax candle. So the lemongrass is going to add a real bright, refreshing shine to the drink and a full lemon flavour. In a moment, I'm going to hand you the cup, but don't touch yet. I'm going to then give you a spoon. On the spoon is a cascara jelly, cascara being the fruit, dried fruit of the coffee cherry. It's on the table if you fancy giving it a smell. And the cascara is just going to add vibrancy to the cup. So just bear with me. Like to take a spoon and start stirring. So keep stirring until the jelly falls off the spoon.
And 1 minute to go.
Ah. Okay, get stirring. So once it's dissolved, I want you to take one sip, one small sip. But imagine you're out having a picnic, the bees are buzzing around you, and you're drinking homemade sweet still lemonade. Next stage of the drink, I want you to add your own shot of sparkling water, and that's going to take the drink from the lemonade to a lemon sherbet. Right, enjoy. Give it a little mix once you've poured it in there.
30 seconds remaining.
Thank you, time.
Ladies and gentlemen, big hand, please, Hayley Draper.
Clock will start then, and we'll make the time codes as you go along. And very best of luck.
Aroma is one of the most exciting experiences we can get from coffee. It's aroma that leads you to that one coffee on the cupping table before you've tasted any. It's aroma when you open that first bag or grind that first shot and really get excited about what you're about to drink. Today I'm going to start by brewing some espresso, and as I serve it, I like to check the creme. I look for a tan leather colour and a thin but persistent layer, and then stop. Don't drink. I'm going to demonstrate and give you some really specific instructions on how I like to experience the coffee. Now whilst I'm gone, I like to take these grinders from in front of you, turn the handle at the top clockwise until they go quiet, unscrew the bottom, and take a deep sniff of the aroma. To be your first impression of my coffee, loads of citrus, loads of sweetness, and I'll be back in a minute. Thank you. Take touches. Oh, I'm going to purge this grinder first. And then I'm going to brew these two shots at the same time.